Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm continuing my painting of giraffe, and I'm just putting the markings on the back of the giraffe, or the body of the giraffe. So I'll continue with that. So I'll come over here, and I'm taking a mixture of burnt umber and burnt sienna. It's going to mix together here, show you that. The small liner brush, a little bit of medium to thin it down. I'm just sort of coming along here, I'm drawing the shape of these patterns, and I'm kind of filling them in. You just have to kind of take your time when you're doing this. Really talk too much for this video because it's just kind of a repetitive action here. Just put these on here. Probably gonna have to go over it 2 or 3 times before it gets the way we want it to be to get it to show up opaque enough. I'll do the part in the middle here, which is darkest, so I can kind of focus on that, because when it gets over here, it's a little bit lighter. So I think the larger ones here that will work. Painting the outside of the pattern first and kind of filling it in. Just like that. Paint the outside of that one. And sort of get a little bit narrower as they go up the neck. Kind of do that. establish that. Burnt sienna. Burnt sienna is kind of like a reddish brown color. It's a nice color. It's a little bit wider as it comes to this side of the neck, so it looks like it's more towards us. If you like my videos, please be sure to like, share, and subscribe. That kind of helps my channel. I appreciate that if you could do that. Early in the morning here, in my porch slash studio here in Jupiter, Florida. That's where I work out of. So it'll look a little bit more like a giraffe. You have an area here that kind of comes here, and then a little bit of a separation right in there. Find that a little bit better. Just sort of continuing on with these patterns. It's kind of repetitive. repetitive. Repetitious. Patterns on this side. Sure the paint underneath is dry before I try to do this. That's important. If you don't, it's going to be hard to get this to stick on there. Unless the paint, you can get it to stick unless if the underpaint is real thick and you're using a overpaint that's real thin with a lot of medium in it, you could probably get it to stick. But you're better off just letting it dry and then going over it to get a better coverage. Get the stick on there better. Goes down the leg. The patterns are still dark, but they get smaller there. So let's make those patterns small. That's smaller yet. Smaller and smaller as they go down. Let me put a couple larger patterns up here to sort of connect it. Like I said, it gets a little lighter over here, a little bit lighter over here, but I want to put in some of the darker ones first. Those dark ones there. running out of paint. Sienna and burnt umber together, mixed. Yeah, a little low on paint. Small over here as it goes around. To make them lighter, I just put it, as I'm running out of paint, I create more of them. That kind of automatically lightens it. I go down. A little bit of darkness there. And then we come back to over here. I do want a couple lighter ones in there, but I will add a little bit of white there. Just gonna knock that down a little bit. On the background, just getting all that out there a little bit. And then I'm going to keep coming down here on this side. Make smaller patterns. Small patterns, we'll let that taper down to the bottom there. Tap them in there. separate the hind leg from the front leg. And we have this one to do. A little bit more coming down here. There are less of these on this front leg. There's a little white area here, so I'm just going to leave that blank for now. Get further down, it gets almost completely covered there. This pattern, so I'll fill it in more. Gets down here towards the grass, you can't see him as much anyway, so you kind of fill it in more there. Fill it in more over here. All right, so those are the patterns of a giraffe. Just real simple, just kind of underpainted. There's a lot of loose paint on here, so I'll let the canvas dry evenly or parallel to the ground. And I'll let this dry completely, then I'll start light. I don't need to let this part dry. I'll start, next time I'll work on the grass. I'll make a new video for that. And thanks for watching. Appreciate it. See you guys next time.